Hello and welcome to another video. If you're new to this channel, my name is Dennis, and on this channel we are all about productivity and educational tips. So if you consider yourself as an instructor, a student, or a young professional, consider subscribing to this channel for more actionable content. In this video, I'm going to share with you 5 Google Drive tips that will make you more productive at work and at school. And if you stay to the end of this video, I will share a pro tip with you that will make you more productive in what you do. Let's get started. I know sometimes it's quite difficult to follow the tips and tricks that people share with you because you really want to find out how it applies to you at your work and at school and in your own peculiar situation. And so what I will do in this video is to share some scenarios with you that these tips and tricks will be more productive for you. Tip number one, how to create shortcuts and use shortcuts in Google Drive. So you are at work or school and you have to share a document with a colleague. Now, instead of just sharing this document, what I can do, I can quickly create a shortcut of this document with my colleague. That way, my colleague will access the shortcut version of this document. Now, to be able to create a shortcut, what I normally will do is to select the document, right-click, and go to Add Shortcuts to Drive. But since I'm all about productivity, there is an easier way to do this, and that will save you a couple of minutes. You get what I mean? So, with the document selected, hold down Shift and Z together and a dialog box will open. Select your drive, click on the small arrow here and select the folder that you want to share and select Add Shortcut. You'll be prompted and a shortcut is created in the folder. My colleagues will be able to access the shortcut version of this file and be able to do all the edits and all the additions that they want to do. The interesting thing is working with shortcut is that whatever corrections they make in the shortcut will show up in the original. So that in case the shortcuts get deleted, I will still have the original file to fall back on. Tip number two, search your Google Drive document from your browser. If I wanted to search something from my Google Drive, usually you go into your Google Drive and then you use the search bar in your Google Drive to search for your document. But you can search for your files and other data straight from your browser. And to do this, you must first make sure that the settings are enabled in your Google Chrome browser. I use Google Chrome, but make sure that it is enabled in the browser that you use. Go to Settings. Click on Search Engines and then select Manage Search Engines and then click on Add. In the first box, type Google Drive and in the second, type drive.google.com and in the URL space, type this link. I will provide this link in the description so that you can add it to your settings. Once that is done, click on Save. Now to search from your browser, type in the keyword, which is Drive, hit the Tab key, and now you can search the document that you're looking for. So practically, this will save you some seconds rather than going through the loop of going to Google Drive and going to the search and typing in your document or file that you're looking for. And here's a pro tip. You can use this tip to optimize your search for Google and also YouTube. Tip number three, using the search within function. So assuming I'm looking for a specific file and I know which folder contains that specific file, instead of using the search bar to search for the file name and then looking for the file, I can go within that specific folder and search for the file that I'm looking for. So for instance, if what I'm looking for is located in the colleagues at work file, what I can do is that I can right-click on this and then select Search Within Colleagues at Work. And once I select that, all the files in the folder opens up to me and then I can search within that specific folder. Enable the offline sync. Friends, you're going to love me for this. There are some times that you are out of Wi-Fi zone or you are having connectivity issue and you've typed a document that you've saved in your drive and you were wondering if that is going to upload in time. Enabling the offline sync means that you can continue to work in your Google Drive documents, and once you are connected to an internet, that file is going to instantaneously sync to your Google Drive. It means that you're not going to lose your data and you're not going to have that headache whether your data is saved or not. To enable this feature, go into your email account and hit on Settings, select See All Settings, and then go to offline and make sure that enable offline mail is selected, and then select one of these options. I like to go with keep offline data on my computer or device, and so I select that, and then I will click on save, and my email will refresh. Offline has been enabled, and anytime I work offline, it is going to save automatically when I connect to an internet. The next step is working with keyboard shortcuts. I am not a fan of using keyboard shortcuts, but since I want to be a productivity guru, working with keyboard shortcuts actually saves you time. Imagine the number of clicks that you have to go through to do one action. If I wanted to rename a document, I can simply right click on it and then select rename and type the name and then hit OK. But with keyboard shortcuts, all that I have to do is to press N, and that will bring the rename dialog box up, and then I can type the name that I want to type and then hit enter. That saved me 3 additional steps, and that is maybe a fraction of a second, maybe 3 seconds, but that is time that you can use for other things. In most cases, you do not have to enable this, but if in case your keyboard shortcuts are not working, you have to go back into your Gmail account and then click on settings, see all settings, and then in the general tab, scroll all the way down till you see keyboard shortcuts. If it is off, make sure to turn it on, and now you can use keyboard to do a few things. The basic shortcuts that I use is what I just showed you. If I wanted to rename a document, I can simply tap N and that will rename a document. If I wanted to create a new folder, I can press down the shift key and hold F and a new folder will come up. I can name this YouTube and hit create, and my folder is created. If I wanted to go to the left side of the screen, which is the navigation pane, what I can do is press down G and N, and that would activate the navigation pane, and I can use the arrow keys to go up and down and the enter key to select where I want to go. Since you stayed with me to the end of the video, here is a pro tip. This tip will make your life easier. When you find something on Instagram or Facebook or anywhere on the internet and you find it very helpful to your work that you do or maybe to an assignment, there is an easy way to extract text from photographs or to extract text from PDF. The other day, I chanced on this image on Instagram and I found the content very helpful. And to be able to extract the text, what I did was first to take a screenshot, upload it to my Google Drive, and then open my Google Drive, right click, and then open with Google Doc. It took obviously a few minutes. You'd see that the first page is the photograph that I opened with Google Docs, and the second page and the third page contain all the texts that are included in the photo that I uploaded. I hope you found these tips very helpful. Comment below and let me know how you are using these tips and tricks to make your life more productive at work or at school. If there is anything that you'd like to know more about, reach out to me on my social media handles or comment in the comment section below and I will get back to you. Support my channel to grow by hitting the subscribe button and liking this video and sending it to your friends and family to subscribe and also join in the fun of learning new tips and tricks that comes out every single week. And so let's make a date next time. As always, have a good one.